We talked about this story literally while it was breaking on Sunday afternoon, but I thought it was important that we do a follow-up video on this. There has been so much more information released about Bishop Sycamore, information that I did not know about the other day when we talked about this. I have never pretended to be an investigative journalist. I consider myself to be more of an analyst, so to speak. Investigative journalism is not my forte. I find stories mainly dealing with the woke media, and I sift through all of the garbage to tell you guys what I think the truth really is. That's what we do here. I spent about an hour doing research on Bishop Sycamore on Sunday afternoon. All of the information that I found and presented to you guys, I found it in the first 5 minutes. The other 55 minutes I spent researching, I couldn't find anything else about this program. Their website, for example, if you can call it a website, it's basically blank. It looks like a website that was put together by a high school IT class, perhaps a high school that is online only and doesn't have a physical building for classes, much like Bishop Sycamore, which is beginning to look like a complete scam. This is also starting to look worse and worse for ESPN. Like I told you guys the other day when I gave you my theory of what happened here, this is what happens when you make your decisions through the lens of race. ESPN's claiming that they were duped, they were scammed. They're trying to push the blame to any and everyone else. This is not like an 85-year-old woman being scammed by Supreet, who is calling her from his bunker in Pakistan, trying to get her credit card and social security number. ESPN is supposed to be a first-class organization, and they're claiming that they've been scammed by some third-rate high school football coach? I ain't buying it. I don't believe their story. I am not buying this. I just find it hard to believe that ESPN didn't do at least a little bit of due diligence before putting a high school football team on national television. To the media's credit, they have done a lot of digging on this story, and I'm about to share with you some of the latest information that they have discovered about Bishop Sycamore and their head coach, Roy Johnson. This Roy Johnson, quite the character and quite the career criminal. He currently has a bench warrant out for his arrest for domestic violence. The bench warrant was issued July 2nd. Meaning this dumbass went on national television revealing his location to the world with an active warrant out for his arrest. There are some brilliant criminals in this world. Roy Johnson, not one of them. He's also set to go to trial for defaulting on a six-figure loan. He's also facing a civil lawsuit for over six figures for failing to pay for hotel rooms on road trips. Oh, that's not all. Not all. He also has a dispute with a paintball park in Ohio. Apparently, he brought his football team there to play paintball one day. They spent about 4 hours there, ran up a nice tab, left a bogus credit card for payment. Are you starting to see a trend here with Roy Johnson? The head coach of Bishop Sycamore is a woman-beating con artist who doesn't pay his bills. I have a couple of questions here. Number one, how in the hell was this man licensed to coach high school football team, high school kids? And number two, how did ESPN not know about any of this? Of course, now that all of this information has been widely publicized, Bishop Sycamore has fired Roy Johnson. Just happened a couple of hours ago. But I go back to the question, how did ESPN not know about any of this? I have been looking into this story all day. I can't even verify if Bishop Sycamore is an actual school, a real school. Schools with Bishop in their name are usually associated with the Catholic Church. Bishop Sycamore, they claim to call Columbus, Ohio home. Catholic Church in Ohio has no association with them. Bishop Sycamore, like I said, they claim to be based in Ohio, but they're not a part of the Ohio High School Athletic Association. Instead, they actually belong to the Texas Christian Athletic League. With all this scandalous information coming to light, other high school programs, they're starting to cancel games against Bishop Sycamore, and rightfully so. They put together one of the toughest schedules in the country, but it is not safe for these kids to play against top programs. Of course, whoever the hell's running Bishop Sycamore, they don't give a damn about the safety and the health of their players. 48 hours before they played IMG Academy on Sunday afternoon, they played against another team Friday night. 48 hours before. A sizable portion of the players on the roster, they play on both sides of the ball, offense and defense. NFL players constantly complain when they had to play a game on Sunday, turn around, play another one on Thursday night. That's NFL players. That's 4 days difference. These kids played Friday night in Pennsylvania, then had to travel to Ohio, play again Sunday afternoon. They literally had no rest. I'm sticking by my theory that I gave you guys on Sunday. I know some of you guys didn't necessarily agree that woke politics had anything to do with this. I'm not saying that it's the only reason, but I do believe that it did play some part in the decision to nationally televise Bishop Sycamore. You cannot tell me that ESPN is this incompetent. They're trying to blame Paragon Marketing, the third party that brought Bishop Sycamore to the table. But at the end of the day, ESPN decides what airs on ESPN, not Paragon Marketing. One of two things happened here. This is either gross incompetence and negligence by ESPN, or the network that makes all decisions based through the lens of race saw an African-American head coach, a mainly black football team, and took them at face value. They believed them when they said they had a roster full of D1 talent. ESPN tried for months to find an opponent for IMG Academy for Sunday afternoon. Couldn't find one. So Bishop Sycamore falls in their lap, and they put him on TV. A spokesperson from Paragon was asked about their processes when checking schools. And he said that they do checks on coaching staffs. They check rosters for player rankings. They look at past schedules and results. Basically, Paragon and ESPN do sort of a background check on the coaches and the programs before deciding to put them on national television. So someone please explain to me how they missed all this information. How did they miss it? How did they miss the fact that the head coach of Bishop Sycamore is a criminal? How did they miss the fact that the football team's only won 5 games in 3 years? How the hell did they not know that this team had just played a game on Friday night? If the agenda did not play a role in any of this, someone please give me a better explanation. I usually don't point the finger without having hard evidence, but just look at how ESPN has made decisions over the last couple of years. When they have layoffs, who are the majority of people laid off? White men. They allowed Maria Taylor to go unpunished for ruining the reputation and career of Rachel Nichols. Not only that, they tried to keep Maria Taylor, and they fired Rachel Nichols. They gave Stephen A. Smith $12 million a year while complaining they didn't have any money and cutting the pay of guys like Kenny Mayne. I made the reference the other day that ESPN's turning into BET. I don't think it's a stretch to say that the agenda played a role in putting Bishop Sycamore on ESPN. Now, of course, once there was backlash, once people were concerned about the health and the safety of these kids, ESPN went into panic mode. They blamed the head coach for lying to them. They blamed Paragon for not doing its due diligence. This is ESPN's fault. You can call it incompetence. You can call it negligence. You can call it whatever the hell you want to call it. But this is the kind of thing that happens when every decision that you make is based on race. I think it's cowardly and absolutely ridiculous that ESPN refuses to shoulder any of the blame for this situation, which is typical behavior of the damn wokers. But by refusing to acknowledge this mistake, it further damages the credibility of ESPN. Hell, ESPN had already lost most of their credibility anyway. But this was an opportunity for them to at least try to get some of it back. Even if they came out and said, "Hey, we were negligent. We were incompetent. We did not do our due diligence. We did not do what we were supposed to do. But this won't happen again." I could have respected that. I could have respected it. ESPN, they still would have taken some heat from the media, but at least they were man enough to own their mistake. Instead, they lie about it. They try to point the finger at everyone but themselves. And ESPN destroyed what little credibility they had left. All right, time to let me know what you think. You guys tell me how you think this happened. Did woke politics or the woke agenda, did it play a role? And if it didn't, you tell me how you think it happened. Was it just incompetence and negligence? Sound off in the comments below. Make sure to like and subscribe. Click the notification bell to receive all notifications from the channel. Best way to contact me is by email at btlkc84@gmail.com, kc_btl84 on Twitter. I will see you guys tomorrow.